AJ here with Stronglife Physiotherapy. I enjoy lifting weights and staying active, and in the process of doing this, I seem to have strained a muscle in my forearm. It's nothing bad, but it is bothersome, so I'm going to do some dry needling to speed up the recovery process, and I thought this would be a great opportunity to demonstrate what dry needling is. And hey, it's not very often that you get to see a doctor take his own medicine, so watch and enjoy. Just a disclaimer though, I will be sticking some needles into my arm, so if that kind of thing bothers you, you might want to look away. But the needles I use are so thin, they don't even cause any bleeding, so just a heads up. The muscle I'm targeting is the supinator, which is the muscle responsible for this motion right here, and is located in the upper forearm, has some trigger points right here that we'll be hitting. But first, I'm going to sanitize the hands. Prep the skin with an alcohol wipe. And let's go for it. So we'll locate the trigger point, which is there. And we'll just tap the needle in place. Twist on it. I can feel that radiate a little bit into the forearm, so I know I'm hitting a good spot. I'll probably do a couple more needles. Twist. I'll just get one more. Okay. Not too bad. And I'm also going to hook up some electrical stimulation, which enhances the effects of the needling. Just clip that on. And turn that up. So the electrical stimulation helps the effectiveness of the needling. The needles conduct electricity and it delivers it right down to the trigger point in the muscle where it's needed, instead of having to travel from the surface down to the muscle like with an electrode. It causes some twitching. It's definitely an interesting sensation, but it's not painful. I usually leave the needles in place for about 15 minutes and let them work their magic. Dry needling works by causing tight muscles to release. It also releases natural pain-relieving chemicals in the body. You get an increase in blood flow and a small inflammatory response, which brings cells to the area to help accelerate the healing process. All right, time's up. Let me go ahead and take these needles out. It usually feels better and looser immediately after needling. You'll also get some aching, which lasts a day or two and isn't too bad. But dry needling is very effective for many conditions: low back pain, neck pain, headaches, muscle strains and spasms, tendonitis, TMJ, plantar fasciitis, and many others. But I hope you like this video. Thanks for watching. If you did like it, give it a thumbs up. Have a great day and stay strong. Now, I normally don't do this on my patients, but you can use different frequencies. They have different reactions with the muscles. So if I increase the frequency of my pulse, you can see as it speeds up, but then it'll activate the supinator muscle, causing that to turn outwards.